Hi everyone, I am Beatrice. In today's video, we'll look at multiple sclerosis. So we'll be looking at the pathophysiology, the signs and symptoms, how to diagnose this condition, and how to manage it, including nursing intervention and some teachings you'll be offering to the patient. Before the end of this video, as usual, we'll look at some NCLEX-style questions that will test your knowledge on this topic. So if you are ready for today's lecture, let's begin. Multiple sclerosis is a chronic and progressive disease of the central nervous system and is characterized by destruction of the myelin sheath. So this myelin sheath is a protective covering of the axons. So it covers and protects the axons to help in proper transmission of impulses. Now this disease is an autoimmune disease, so that means the immune system attacks itself. And it's characterized by a period of remission where the patient gets better, feels as if there is nothing happening, and also a period of exacerbation, or what we say relapse, where the situation becomes so worse and the patient begins to manifest all the signs and symptoms. Now, the pathophysiology of multiple sclerosis, first of all, is an autoimmune disease, like I said, so we can't really lay a hand on what is causing it. It's just the immune system attacking itself. So the first thing that happens is that the immune system attacks the myelin sheath, so that protective covering, and that will lead to inflammation and demyelination. So when it attacks the myelin sheath, the next thing that there will be inflammation, and as that inflammation begins to occur, it begins to destroy that myelin sheath. That's what we call demyelination. And then because of this, it will lead to formation of multiple plaques or multiple scars. That's where the name multiple sclerosis is coming from. Sclerosis has to do with formation of scar tissues, and this scar tissues is hardened. So because of that, it disrupts the function between the brain and the body. So there will be no proper transmission of impulses from the brain spinal cord to the rest of the body. The best way to remember multiple sclerosis, think of MS. Now, multiple sclerosis, destruction of the myelin sheath. So I think that's the best way you can remember multiple sclerosis. The signs and symptoms of multiple sclerosis you need to know include vision problems like diplopia, that's double vision. We also have nystagmus. So nystagmus has to do with involuntary movement of the eye, so where there is uncontrollable movement of the eye. Also, patient will experience blurred vision. And then bowel and bladder dysfunction. Remember, there's a disruption in communication between the brain and the entire body. So the patient could experience incontinence, urgency, even difficulty in passing urine. So a lot of those bowel and bladder movements. Then also, the patient could experience muscle spasticity. At times, the muscle become rigid, become hardened, and they could experience spasm muscle. And then at times, the muscles also could be weak, especially in the lower extremities. They could experience weakness. And then paresthesia, by tingling, which is tingling sensation. Other symptoms also include memory changes. At times they could have problem concentrating. At times also they could have difficulty comprehending. They can forget things easily. So another thing is problem with balance, what we call atasia. So at times they find it difficult to coordinate their movements. And then fatigue, they get easily tired. And then dysphagia, they could have problem with swallowing. That's what we call difficulty in swallowing. And then they experience tremors, even vertigo, where they feel like either the room is spinning or they themselves are spinning. And then we have decreased perception. So with decreased perception, this is a safety issue because they may not be able to differentiate between temperature changes, when something is very hot or when something is very cold. So they get burned. That's an issue that you need to watch out for, and you need to also teach the patient. We'll look at that shortly. Abnormal reflexes, they will experience hyperreflexia. And then emotional disturbances like anxiety, even depression. Now let's look at how to diagnose multiple sclerosis. The first one is presence of multiple scars, or what we call CNS plaque on MRI. And then another one is when they do a lumbar puncture or spinal tap, is going to show increased protein, particularly gamma globulin. So when they check, they analyze the cerebrospinal fluid, they test it, there's going to be an increased presence of gamma globulin. Meanwhile, in the serum, it's going to be normal. So that's the sign that something's going on, there's destruction of something that's affecting the brain or the myelin sheath. Now, management of multiple sclerosis, including nursing intervention. they use medications like immunosuppressant because these are not autoimmune diseases. So to reduce that effect of the immune system attacking itself, they use corticosteroids, especially during the period of exacerbation. They use steroids. And then interferon beta. So this one is used to prevent or reduce the episode of relapse or exacerbation. And then also they can give muscle relaxant, especially during that time of muscle spasticity where they are feeling the muscle is so stiff and tense. They could give them muscle relaxant. And that would be most time during that period of exacerbation. And also anti-inflammatories also can be prescribed. Remember, there's an inflammation and then demyelination. Now, also you'll be teaching them some things about the medication, like corticosteroid, it could lead to increased risk for infection. It could lead to hyperglycemia. And for interferon beta, they could feel that flu-like symptoms. And generally, a patient that has multiple sclerosis, you are going to teach them when they are on any medication and they feel that sign of infection or like temperature changes, they should report this to their healthcare provider. Nursing intervention. As a nurse, you have a lot of things you'll be doing. You'll be teaching them and you'll also be caring for them. So you are going to ensure that there's energy conservation. So what we mean by this is, remember, this patient easily get tired, they feel fatigued. So when you are caring for them, you do what we say, cluster care. So you don't just involve them all the time. Most times you do some of their care together when you see that they have some energy. Also, for that diplopia, you can apply eye patch to one of the eyes, so to reduce that double vision where they are seeing more than one image. And then regular elimination pattern, because they have problem with elimination, so you want to encourage that regular elimination habit. And then diet high in fiber. Remember, they have problem with elimination. So to reduce or prevent constipation, it's important they eat food high in fiber. And then you want to encourage them to eat food high in potassium, like banana, because potassium supports muscle and nerve function. And then low-fat diets. Then encourage increased fruit intake. And then safety measures, very important. Now, one of the problems or one of the symptoms of multiple sclerosis could be decreased perception. So they may find it difficult differentiating between hot temperature, extremely cold temperature, hot surfaces. So you want to encourage them to use things like bath thermometer so that they can test the temperature of the water before they use it to bathe. And also discourage the use of heating pads, because if it gets so hot, they may not know and they could get burnt. Now, teaching. As a nurse, you're going to be teaching them to avoid some triggers. One of the triggers could be extreme temperature. Either the temperature is very hot or very cold. So teach them to avoid those kind of things. And then illness, especially infection. Then stress is a major trigger. So tell them as much as possible they should rest when they are tired or they are fatigued. And like I mentioned, they should avoid heating pads so that they don't get burned because of that decreased perception. And then the use of bath thermometer is part of the safety measure. They're able to check the temperature of the water before they use it. Now let's look at some NCLEX type questions on multiple sclerosis. Question 1. Multiple sclerosis is primarily characterized by which of the following pathological changes? A. Inflammation of peripheral nerves. B. Destruction of acetylcholine receptors at the neuromuscular junction. C. Autoimmune destruction of the myelin sheath in the central nervous system. D. Ischemic infarction of the brainstem. So the answer would be C. Autoimmune destruction of the myelin sheath in the central nervous system. Question 2. Which of the following symptoms would the nurse expect in a client with multiple sclerosis? A. Increased deep tendon reflexes and spasticity. B. Bradycardia and hypotension. C. Jaundice and right upper quadrant pain. And D. Polyuria and dry mucous membrane. The answer would be A. Increased deep tendon reflexes and spasticity. Question 3. Which nursing intervention is most appropriate for a client with multiple sclerosis who is experiencing fatigue? A. Schedule activities in the early evening. B. Limit physical activities to prevent exhaustion. C. Cluster care to allow longer rest period. D. encourage frequent position changes? So the answer would be C, cluster care to allow longer rest periods. Look at option B, limit physical activities to prevent exhaustion. We don't actually limit physical activities. Also, we encourage exercise, but it will be at the level they are able to tolerate. Now, the last question. A nurse is teaching a client with multiple sclerosis who is prescribed interferon beta. Which statement by the client indicates a need for further teaching? A, I will monitor my temperature regularly. B, I may feel flu-like symptoms after the injection. C, I will report signs of infection right away. And D, I can stop my injection once my symptoms improve. So the correct answer will be D, I can stop my injection once my symptoms improve. Now, interferon beta is given to patient, it's going to be for a long-term period. It's to prevent relapse. So when a patient makes a statement that they can stop their injection once they feel better or when their symptoms improve, you know that they need further teaching. Every other options are correct. They need to monitor their temperature. They need to be sure that also they are not having any sign of infection. They may feel flu-like symptoms. That's one of the side effects after having that injection interferon beta. So that wraps up today's topic of multiple sclerosis. If you find this video useful, please like this video, share it, leave your comment, and subscribe for more educational videos. Thanks for watching.